Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. We are going to dive straight into how to get shaders for Minecraft Education Edition. So we're going to head over to Google and we're going to type in MCPEDL, which I assume stands for Minecraft Pocket Edition Downloads. Now, of course, we are using Education Edition and not Pocket Edition, but it works, so let's go ahead and do it. So here we're going to click shaders and then just scroll through the shaders. Simple. It's organized by latest, but you can organize it however you would like. Some of them take you off the website to download, some of them don't. I actually am just going to show you today my favorite one. So if you trust me on your decision making, just want to leave it up to me, then just go straight ahead and type in DGR like so. Go to DGR shader here, scroll right the way down, well, not all the way, because someone's kindly posted the lyrics to Never Gonna Give You Up by Rick Astley. That's nice. But once you get past all of that, you'll get to here. Just click down Width Blade Movement 2.7. I think that's the one I've got, or version 3. I'm sure it works fine as well. I'm going to go for Width Blade Movement. That's the grass moving around. And just click Download. It's a nice one. It doesn't take you off the website. You can change your operating system here. And then that will just fire up down here. Click on it, and it will open up Minecraft Education straight away. And it will start importing your shader. Now, I've been using the shader recently just to make the thumbnails for my videos look a little bit better. But they're kind of nice fun to play around with. They replace a lot of the textures and lighting. But it is a bit more intensive on your computer. Luckily, a lot of the shaders are designed for Pocket Edition, which is used on phones and iPads and stuff like that. So if you're on a half-decent laptop or PC or Mac, as I am, it should run pretty well. So once we're in Minecraft Education, we are going to create a new world. And I'll put it on creative and world type infinite. Yeah, that's fine. So down here on resource pack, here are the active packs. So this is just the normal one that's installed, global resources. We'll go down to my packs, and here we have DGR shaders version 3. I've installed a few and I think this one is the best, so click it once and activate it, and then we'll click play, and I'll talk to you a little bit about shaders some more while it loads. So when you create a world with a shader activated in the resource pack, it will save that. So when you go back to it, it will still have that shader activated. But you can just do go into the same menu that you did then and deactivate it and activate a different one. You can activate multiple shaders at once if you think your computer can handle it. And you can just have a play around and get the results that you want. All right, so this is with the shader activated. And of course, as you can see, the lighting and stuff is very, very different. Certainly buildings and stuff look a lot different. I noticed the biggest difference if I go to time set sunset. There we go. And you know, the sun's been replaced with kind of a more realistic looking sun, and you get the light on here. It does slow your computer down a bit, which is why actually you can use it when you're building. But I just use it for taking thumbnails and stuff like that. I quite like the way it looks. Every now and again, if I'm working on something to turn the shader on, it's not something that's going to change the way the game works particularly. But there we are. If you were interested in getting shaders to work on Minecraft Education Edition in 2021, there's a super quick way of getting it done. All right. Now, later on in the week, I'm going to be doing a video that's going to be printing some pixel art, line by line, like a printer. That's coming out on Friday, so make sure you subscribe to the channel, and you'll see that as soon as it's uploaded. But until then, have a good one, and I'll see you guys later.